ओके, टेस्ट डेटा, सो लेट्स टॉक अबाउट इट. द डेटा इन सेल्सफोर्स टेस्ट क्लासेस इज ट्रांजिएंट. दैट मींस व्हाटएवर डेटा यू क्रिएट ऑटोमेटिकली गेट्स रोल्ड बैक. इट नेवर गेट्स सेव्ड इनटू द डेटाबेस. एंड अनलेस अंटिल यू राइट डाउन सी ऑल डेटा इक्वल्स टू, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू एक्सेस द रिकॉर्ड व्हिच आर ऑलरेडी देयर इनटू दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑब्जेक्ट. राइट, यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू डू दैट. So in that case, what should we do? We want to execute a particular test class, all the unit test methods over it, for it, and we want to create test data, right? So sometimes what happens is we create test data, and we create test data in each and every method, right? In each and every test case, because we want to use it in each and every test case, and the like the in the test method where you're going to create that data. It's gonna be vanished after the execution of that particular unit test. Then you'll again have to create it for another unit test or for another test method. So in order to have a test data to all to like which is available to all of the unit tests or all of the test methods, what we do is we create the test data in the test setup method. And in this test setup method, what we do is we set up the test that we're going to execute later on. So we create another method, and in that method we create all of the records and everything that we want to execute that particular test. And after doing that, after doing this test setup and everything, what we exactly do is, like, the data gets created and it becomes available to all the unit tests and all the test methods automatically. That's what it is. And this is the first method that gets executed whenever we run the test on that particular class. Right. So listen to this very carefully once again, while with an example, right? Test dot start test, test dot stop test, right? This is already done. Where is the example? Over here. So there is a method, static void test method one, right? This is a method. This is a test method. So instead of creating the records in here, I've created a record over here. In this test setup method, right? I've created two test account records and I'm inserting it into the database. So when I'm going to execute this test class 5, the first method that will get executed will be the test setup method, right? And what is the purpose of this test setup method? This is basically used to create the test data on which or based on which we are going to run the test. Is it clear, everyone? Okay. So in this case, after like creating this, give me a second. Yeah. So after executing this particular method, this test setup method, the data will be available until unless this whole, the, like all the test methods of this particular class gets executed. And after the execution of the test methods or the unit test in this particular class, the records that are being created by the test setup method will get rolled back. So it will also get rolled back. The data that you're creating into test setup method is again test data, and test data is always transient. Right? Clear, everyone? Got the answer? You can. That's how we're going to use it, by the way. But over here, what I've done is I've created the data, inserted it into the database. And over here, with the help of query, I've got those records. That's what I'm doing, right? That's it. Is it clear, everyone? What is the use of test setup method? Exactly. So instead of creating the test data for each and every unit test, what we do is we create a test setup method which creates the test data for every unit test in that particular class. Is it clear? Why is the importance of this method with any real life? Why is the, or what is the importance, I think? Importance of this method with any real life example. Okay, let me tell you. So you want to test that whether your trigger, like not triggers, but yeah. So let's say that you have created 5 unit tests that are going to test that whether your contact objects pages and contact objects programs or controllers that you have created are working fine or not. So in that case, you'll be having 5 different unit test methods. And instead of writing down the code to create the test data in all of those 5 methods, you can just create a test setup method in which you can create the test data which will be available to all of those 5 unit tests. So it will reduce the code redundancy. It will also allow you to test different functionalities onto the same set of records or onto the same test data. So that's what is the importance of test setup method. Test setup method. In which method you're going to execute that? Insert the DML statement is an executable statement, and every executable statement written is written inside a method. So where are you going to write that down? This one. Test method one. So in this case, if you're going to create it over here, and if you're going to create it over here, what is the chances that this method will get executed first when you're going to execute this test class? Is there any predefined order? In that case, if there is test method 1 and test method 2, and you've created the test data in test method 1, might be test method 2 gets executed first. In that case, test method 2 will not be available with the data that you are expecting it to be available with. So then in that case, there is code redundancy and there is not same data available. So let's say you've created an Apex class and you're trying to, in that Apex class, you've got insert functionality, update functionality, and delete functionality. And you want to try all of that onto the same data. First, you want to insert that record, then you want to update it, then you want to delete it. So there are 3 unit tests that you have created for that. And you want similar data or same data for the complete testing of that functionality. So in that case, you're going to create the data in the test setup method, not in each and every unit test. Make sense? Any other question, anyone? So this test ACCTC, okay, will be available for all the test methods, and we don't have to fetch it for all the test methods. It will be available, this will, if you want it to be available to every, every test method, then in that case, you can declare it with as, just a second. No, you can't declare it as a member variable. Okay, I have to make it static, just a second. So in the question that you're asking, Abhishek, is basically, can this test ACCTC will be available to all the test methods? So it will only be available to all the test methods if you create it as a member variable of that particular class rather than declaring it into the method. If you're going to declare it into the method, then the scope of this test ACCTC will be limited to this particular method only. But if you want its scope to be available to the complete class, then in that case, you'll have to declare it as a member variable in that particular test class. I hope that answers your question. Because the static method, we want to use this variable in a static method. And in a static method, you can only use static variables, not an instance variable. Kahan, tell me, insert. It's an executable statement. How can you write down for loop without a method, right? It's an executable statement. So outside a class, you can only declare the things. But executable statements can only be written down in the method. Got it? Clear, everyone? The use of test setup method. Write it down if you want to. Clear? Now, guys, tell me one thing. I've got a question for you. This is to test the Apex classes, right? And in Apex class, how much code coverage is required? At least 75%, right? And in triggers, more than zero. It's not zero, it's more than zero, right? At least some coverage is required in triggers. But how to test triggers? How to test triggers? How to test the code that is written in triggers? But still, we want to test that whether it is executing according to our functionality or not. We can test the helper class, there's no doubt. But how are we going to get to know that when I'm going to insert, then only it is going to be working this way? Getting it? So I want to check that in before insert, is it working fine or not? That method that I've written down in helper class is fine. But what about testing a particular trigger? How to test that? हाँ नो एनी वन फ्रॉम द चैट हाउ टू टेस्ट द ट्रिगर्स वेरी इजी आई एम टेलिंग इट यू You're absolutely right. So it's simple. When does the execution of trigger happens? When you insert a record, when you delete a record, when you perform any DML operation. So what do we need to do in order to test that functionality? Perform a DML except like DML operation. That's all what you have to do. There's no annotation here, nothing like that. So I want to test trigger 4 or something like that. Let's say. So over here, I've created a test class, simple test class, and in that I have created a test trigger method. And what I'm doing is I'm creating records and I'm inserting it. So before insert and after insert will be called yes or no. And if they'll be called, they'll automatically be tested. That's it. And then list account, ACC list to select name, number of employees from account. So this is to test whether the records that I've inserted are getting inserted according to the requirement or not, or are getting inserted into the database or not. If there is any problem that is coming up, then in that case, like with this query, we're not going to get anything as a result. Clear? Read this. If the test method or test class has see all data property set as true, then the query will return all the records of account object in the database, including the ones that we created in the unit test. Otherwise, it will only return the records which we created in the current unit test. We all know about that, right? And over here, I'm printing it all. That's what I'm doing. So currently, if you're going to see the code coverage for the triggers. So this, let's see this trigger helper, right? 0%, 0%. And the triggers, every trigger is 0% right now, right? Let's execute this test. Test Apex trigger 4. Isn't there any method in it? There is. Run. I don't think there is any trigger active. So first we need to activate the triggers. This is Apex trigger 4. This executes on account before insert. Right? Is active. Make it like save it. Now let's have a look. New run. Test Apex trigger 4. Run. Test executed successfully. Let's see what's the code coverage for Apex trigger 4. 100%, right? That's how it goes. And if there is any helper class that it is using or the methods of helper class that it is calling, then in that case, that helper class's code will also get tested, right? Will also be covered in the testing. So that's what it is. Make sense? So whenever you want to test a particular trigger, just understand which database events are there and accordingly make a DML operation in the test class or in the test method or in the unit test. Is it clear? Everyone? Basically, you're writing line down the trigger in the test class. We are writing down the trigger in the test class. No, we are writing down the DML operation in the test class to test that trigger. Clear, everyone? Good. And that's it. You can write it down if you want to. I mean, or it's already there in the notes. Like, if you want to test the triggers, what do you have to do? Okay. Clear, everyone? Huh. So that means if trigger is getting failed, that means your functionality is failed. So testing is correct, na? Clear everyone with this? Okay, next. One more thing. Let's go back to our calculate method. Calculate class. You remember all of this? So these variables are private. Let's say if I'll make this method also as private. What is the like sense of making a method as private? So we can only call this package. It will only be called like a private method will only be called in this particular class, right? A private variable will only be accessible in that particular class, nowhere else, right? So if I make this method as private, and I want to cover its code inside the testing over here, if I'll go to test and if I'll run test calculate, what do you want? Run. So in this case, what is happening? For test calculate, it's not coming up. I don't know why. Calculate and calculator are different classes. See error in the get result. Why? Because that method is private. But if I'm going to execute this code, I want this result function to also come under the code coverage. There will be a lot of private methods in the class that I want to test, right? But I cannot call it in another class or the test class. Then how it's going to work out? I mean, how to test the private class members or how to test the private class methods? So one thing is by calling it in another method which is public. So either call the result get result method in another method so that it gets covered. If you cannot do that, or if you do not want to do that, and if that's not a functionality that you're looking for, then in that case there is an annotation that you can use. Add test visible. Now see, if I'll go to this test class and I'm gonna save this, it'll get saved. Right? It got saved. But if I'll remove this test visible, or like make it a comment, then let's have a look at this test calculate. Throw an error everywhere where there is a get result method that we're using. Right? So to make private members visible into the test class, you can mark them with at test visible annotation so that they will be private for all the other classes, but for the test classes they will be public. Is it clear, everyone? So one thing is to call the private method in the public method which is already exposed to the test class. Another one is mark it with at test visible annotation. Clear, everyone?